This is the Transformers Authentics Bravo Barricade. I picked up this figure from a local toy shop out here in Manila called Toy Town for about 349 Philippine pesos, which roughly translates to about $6.50. Here's a quick look at the packaging. Interesting, interesting figure. I'm surprised I haven't picked him up much sooner. Let's get this guy out of packaging. And here is Authentics Bravo Barricade out of the box. And man, this figure is amazing. Super amazing figure. You cannot beat this figure. It's just too cool. I mean, for the price point of $6, you get a really, really awesome figure. Great details, great engineering, everything. Superb. This figure is literally on a masterpiece level type of figure. Let's take a closer look at the details of this figure. The figure stands at about 10.5 centimeters tall, or about 4 1/8 inches tall. And for comparisons, here he is with the blue streak or silver streak, and here he is with deluxe Bumblebee. And you can see that he is about 2 millimeters taller than Bumblebee. I mean, that is just amazing. The figure has this amazing sculpt, which is, I believe, a mix of IDW G1, Bayverse, and I don't know, was it Earth Wars? Barricade? They mixed up all of the aesthetics and turned him into sort of like a legacy version of Barricade, if that makes any sense. And I love it. I mean, look at this guy. He's so chunky. He's bulky. I mean, he's not that skinny Bayverse Barricade or G1 Barricade. And he's made of this really nice, lightweight, navy blue plastic and a gray bit. It's very lightweight and it's very, very, very thin plastic. And they did that on purpose so that you don't strain your hand from lifting the figure. You don't get any of that carpal tunnel syndrome for your wrist, because, you know, normally a deluxe class figure is pretty heavy. I mean, so it would strain your wrist just lifting it. Now this one, the whole idea is to bring this figure anywhere. It's like a pocket Transformers figure that you can just play around with, put it in your pocket. And that's what the lightweight material is for. Look at this. It's solid, but it's light. And look at my wrists. There's no strain at all whatsoever just carrying this figure. Articulation for the figure, he's got a ball-jointed neck. No waist swivel, because, you know, you don't really need it, because you can pose him like this and it would look like he's got some waist swivel. He's got a ball-jointed shoulder and additional hinge right here that allows you to distort that shoulder and make him like, yeah, I just scored one for the Decepticon team. Yeah. Okay. He's got ball jointed hips, ball jointed knees. Look at that. Look at that range of motion for his legs. Yeah, 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 yeah. Okay. And then on his ankles, he's got these ball joints that act sort of like a rocker tilt and allow you to move the feet up and down. And you can see a lot of paneling on this figure. He even has this extra bit right here. It feels like he's armored up. I do like that. And what really, really, I think is the best feature of this figure is this immaculate paint job that they've done with it. It's got great white paint. And normally Hasbro botches these white paint apps for their figures. And look at this, just immaculate paint apps, tempos on the figure. You can see that cool Decepticon logo on top of that white paint. More white paint here that will form police. You've got this nice metallic gold finish right there for the windshield. A nice red light bar. Some more white paint right here. Just amazing, amazing paint apps, paint quality. And let's not forget that fantastic head sculpt. Yeah, it really feels like a generation style legacy-fied Barricade. Transformation, it's a little simplistic, but it's involved enough so that it's actually a lot of fun. You fold up the chest, and then the arms are gonna collapse right here, just underneath the chest. And you're gonna slide that chest downwards so you can compress the front part of the car. Now, it's a little tricky That is on purpose, I believe, just to challenge you a bit. So despite being a very simplistic transformation, you get a little bit of a challenge trying to put it together. Okay, the feet, or the legs, I should say, you know, fold them like this. Fold up these armor plating, and you want to rotate. Just rotate this entire side of the leg like that, okay? And then you want to combine these pieces right here. And then finally, actually this one looks pretty cool. It looks very Cybertronian if you keep the roof right there, but you got to slide it back all the way to cover up the feet, the legs, snap it in, and there you go. There is Barricade in his police car alt mode, which kind of does remind me of the Bayverse Barricade, the last night version of his alt mode, which is very cool. And you can see that gold windshield. I mean, you know the figure is premium if they put some metallic gold finish on it. And look at that. Everything else feels like it's tinted, and the only windshield, or the thing that really announces him, is that gold windshield. Look at that. It even has some holes right there. Maybe he can shoot some lasers out of there, but whatever. Very cool. It's got some really nice wheels that really roll, make the car mode roll very, very nicely. You can hear it coming, like rumbling. Wow. That's how you know how smooth it is, when it's so noisy. Look at that. Okay, so very cool. I love it. I love this alt mode. It's a very solid looking alt mode. And it kind of reminds me of the Disney Pixar movie Cars. Look at that. It looks like he's got some eyes on his windshield. He could be like a member of, he could be an escort for Lightning McQueen. Look at that. Very cool. He could be literally starring in a Disney Pixar movie, a sequel to Cars, like maybe a fourth installment of Cars. Look at that. You'll have Barricade. Okay, so for comparisons, here he is with the hubcap, or the Bumblebee cliff jumper mold, and you can clearly see that he is much longer, but again, 2 or 3 millimeters longer in car mode. And in girth and width, look at that. He is a half centimeter wider than your small deluxe class figure in alt mode. Yeah, you cannot beat that. That is just so cool. To transform him back into his robot mode, you just reverse the process. Go ahead and untab the roof, and then you untab the arms and the side of the legs. You want to rotate these leg pieces right here, and then just rotate the feet back into the normal position. Fold down those armor plating. Do the same on the other side. Get that. And then you gotta untab, or just extend the bumper like this. Go ahead and fold out the arms. Fold down that bumper, or the front part of the car, to form the chest. Fold up the roof. And then the arms are just gonna stay right there. And there you go. Look at that. Oh, I forgot to mention, he's got some elbow hinges. And I think that's so cool for an Authentics Bravo figure to have elbow hinges. I mean, come on. Very, very cool figure. Some final thoughts on this Authentics Bravo Barricade. Man, this figure is just absolutely amazing. You cannot beat this figure. It is at a masterpiece level style of Transformers figure with legacy evolution aesthetics, and at the price point of what, a Micromaster or a Battlemaster? Man, this figure is just absolutely amazing. I am going to give it my legendary 1000 over 10 rating, an absolute must have. Especially if you're a big fan of these Authentics Bravos figures and you're just starting up your collection of Transformers, this is a great, great figure to add to your collection. Let me know in the comment section what you guys think of this Transformers Authentics Bravo Barricade. Hit that notification bell so you never miss out on any of my latest video reviews. And if it's your first time here, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.